I made a kit.com profile where you guys can look up some of the gear that I've been using in my setup, and I'm also going to put these controllers on that kit.com profile so then you guys can see where to buy all this stuff from and possibly get this for yourselves. Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Matt Moneybanks, and today I'm going to be talking about Control Freak thumbsticks along with some other thumbsticks that I've picked up over the years. So, to start, we have the basic PS4 controller right here. Now, as you can see, the thumbsticks are actually pretty small, in my opinion, only because I've been using other thumbsticks, but they also tear really easily compared to any other thumbsticks that I've had. Now, I'm going to use this pen right here to try to indicate what I'm talking about. As you can see right here, this tearing around the thumbsticks happens pretty easily on the regular PS4 controller, the basic PS4 controller here. Now, the one thing I hate is having to switch out thumbsticks. That's the most annoying thing about these PS4 controllers. So, I also have this controller here, which has the most basic Control Freak thumbsticks here. And don't mind the squid grips, they're really peeling off on me, so I put some rubber bands on there. It actually has worked out for me, so pro tip, actually. So these Control Freak thumbsticks are actually really good. So they have the most basic height to it, which is the mid height, as you can see on the screen. They are the FPS Freak CQC signature Control Freak thumbsticks, and they actually work great. The $15 I paid for them are worth it, you know what I mean? So if you're looking at some Control Freaks, it's probably best to start basic like these, because you're not going to want to get rid of them. So if you want a more a higher stick to your thumbsticks like these, I would suggest these, only because I really do love these, but their biggest downfall is they pop off a lot when you're playing Call of Duty and other games if you press on them way too hard, which I do a lot. So even though these are really great to have, I love playing with them, they pop off way too easily. And as you can see, I have two different ones, because first of all, I did want the sniper one on the right. I do like to have the dome on the right and then the concave on the left. I don't know, it just helps me play. That's my style, so I like this format better than anything. The large thumbsticks, as you can see here, they're really high up compared to these, which are kind of stubby, but they pop off way too easily and they get on my nerves, to be honest. I've lost, I think, one of these so far, and possibly one of these. I think this one might be in my book bag, but they get lost really easily when you throw them off like that and you're still mid-game. You're not really looking for them. You're trying to finish the game. So I recommend these if you can control the pressure that you put on them, because they're really high and they don't really stand onto your PS4 controller that well. So I don't know how much they cost on Control Freak. I'll put it up on the screen to help you guys out, though. All the links to everything will be in the description as well. Now, this controller here is the SCUF controller with a medium thumbstick and a long thumbstick, as you can see here. This controller allows for switching of the thumbsticks really easily by popping open these keys that you can see at the base of the thumbsticks, and then you can switch them out really easily with any thumbsticks that you want to put in there. So, I gotta be honest, these have been the best thumbsticks that I've had so far. Whereas with these thumbsticks, they don't pop off because they're actually locked into the controller. So there's no like losing these thumbsticks whatsoever. As with these, you're gonna lose them if they start popping off. They pop off really easily. So I do recommend, if you possibly can get a SCUF controller, buy it, because you'll get rid of all the hassle of like losing the long thumbsticks or dealing with short thumbsticks if you're not into them. If you're looking to just get a tiny bit higher thumbstick length than normal, then these thumbsticks I would highly recommend. They have not popped off on me, not even once. These thumbsticks don't really deteriorate too much, but I'm sure over time they will. Whereas I could have a PS4 controller like this, and after 3 months, my thumbsticks are going to look like this, and I'm going to need to change it. This one is still fine, but I'm sure that'll be tearing soon as well. These Control Freak thumbsticks I've had for over, I think, 6 months so far, and the condition is not bad, and I go through thumbsticks pretty easily. As you can see, even with these are not dulled down too much. This one is a little more dulled down than this, but they're not bad at all. when it comes to the scuff thumbsticks, I have not seen much deterioration in them whatsoever. These have held up the best. They are easy to switch out, but I have never switched them out yet. I have bought some new thumbsticks off of eBay because I would like to try the concave thumbsticks. So I ordered them, and they only cost $15, and you get four of them, whereas this pair will cost $15 for just these two. So yes, buying a scuff controller is going to be very expensive, but with the replacement thumbsticks, you'll save a lot of money and you'll get more when it comes to that. So this is my lineup of controllers. With the scuff controller, I do only use it for like Black Ops and fast-paced shooters. But for the most part, I am using this controller and this controller over here. If this has helped, make sure you leave a like on the video. I really do appreciate it. And comment down below any questions that you may have about controllers in general. I'll probably be able to answer that. But until next time, I'll see you guys later. Peace.